Hi everyone, Freak the Knee Out Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it is time for a review of the new Angel Olsen album, All Mirrors. A new record from singer-songwriter Angel Olsen, an album that I have been heavily anticipating ever since the release of her album My Woman, which is a great record. Great 2016 album. High praise from me for that album. It is a project that showcased Olsen's very unique voice and songwriting talents over some of her best production yet. Even though she was far less popular then as she is now, I would argue that Olsen had already proven herself as a songwriter on her 2012 record, which had some great tunes on it, some fantastic vocal performances, but it was very clear past that point that she wanted her sound to branch out and appeal to a wider audience. The results of that desire being Burn Your Fire for No Witness 2 years later, which had Olsen singing over some somewhat generic garage instrumentals. It was very tedious indie folk, a lot of cuts on that one. But you know what? That transition had to happen because we got My Woman out of it. We got a fantastic record out of it. And I'm hoping that Angel can just build from there into All Mirrors, which, as far as the teaser tracks go, was forecasting a pretty big change, with Angel dropping the indie rock and the garage rock, dropping the guitars, essentially, and swapping that out for lush, ornate
orchestral
arrangements and synths. I mean, the instrumental presentation of this record is huge. It feels mammoth at some points. It's really a blowout, and I can see why it's making the splash that it is. But for me, someone who's been enjoying Angel Olsen's music for a while now, something just feels missing. At the very least, there is a major imbalance between Angel's vocals on this record and a lot of the grander, louder, arranged instrumentation, which much of the time she sounds swallowed in. And it's not just Olsen sounding quieter in relation to other instruments in the mix. The unique personality traits of Olsen as a singer and a songwriter too just feel lost in translation, especially when she chooses to sing in this subdued delivery. The songs on this thing have a lot of sauce. They are just swimming in sauce, and what I'm just really dying for in that sauce is more meat on the bone. This is not a very vegan metaphor, but I'm going with it. For example, the track Too Easy, there are portions of this one that sound like a less gratifying version of the synth-led brand of dream pop that Beach House made their name on. Or on Tonight, where Angel can be heard singing very quietly and dramatically along with these very nimble string sections, it sounds almost as if she is going for an Antony and the Johnsons type vibe. I can't really say I'm all that enamored with the barely there, but also somewhat jazzy vocalizations that Angel brings to the track Endgame 2. And even when a tune on this project is more direct, I sometimes end up not really liking how washed out the instrumental is, such as on Summer. The level of reverb on this track and others here just seems really unnecessary. Having it at this level doesn't add that much more to the track. In fact, it makes the whole thing just sound artificially grand. Plus, I'm not really liking the particular arrangement of this track. There are most likely a dozen different ways you could have produced and recorded this song, but instead what we're getting is Kate Bush singing over a dreamy spaghetti western instrumental. Look, I know I'm literally on the opposite end of the enjoyment spectrum as most people listening to this project right now, but again, I'm just not crazy about the way this project sounds. I think a lot of the great things that have made Angel Olsen the artist that she is up until this point are just nowhere to be heard. Plus, I think Angel is kind of stepping into territory on this one that she's not exactly creating a lane for herself in, or dominating in creatively anyway. The song New Love Cassette, for example, to me just sounds like a bland piece of synthetic indie pop that you could get from any number of very uninteresting and moody songwriters out there on the internet right now. The only memorable aspect of this track is the very loud shots of strings that pop in occasionally throughout the track. There's also the total lack of an ending, which the strings are essentially used to divert attention from. There's also the song Spring, which is a somewhat glammy piece of piano pop, easily one of the best songs on the record, enjoying the vocals on this one a lot too, but ultimately, I enjoyed a lot of these ideas so much more when they were on the Wise Blood record earlier this year. We also have one more non-ending to this track too, where we get a rush of strings to, again, divert attention away from the lack of a solid finish. There were really only a handful of tracks on this thing that I genuinely came away enjoying. One, the song Impasse, which the songwriting element is not one of my favorites here. Okay, I have criticisms for the song too, but still, you can't help but admire how incredibly large the instrumental presentation on this track is. The grandest moment on the entire record, and certainly reaches a climactic high that is impressive. We also have the title track, which I loved as a teaser to the album, and I still think stands as one of the more solid tracks here. Originally, it had me excited to hear Angel make this transition into grander instrumentation, into more synths, into longer, more cerebral songwriting structures. The spacey drums, the synths, the twangy guitar leads that pop in here and there all sound like something of a revision out of the Twin Peaks soundtrack. Angel's voice is also incredible on this track, really soars over the icy beds of instrumentation underneath. Also liking what it is on this track, the jaunty strings, the fun skipping groove, the quietly crooned vocals, it's a sweet, quaint little cut, and maybe the most genuinely poppy song on the entire project. Also, the explosive crash cymbals and whooshing strings on the track make it one of the more psychedelic moments on the project too. And the phases of this song keep coming, the weird string bits around the midpoint, the heavier groove, the nightmarish effects laid into Angel's voice in the second half of the track as well. It's amazing. Then there's also Chance, which is a favorite of mine, mostly because it's a solid tune that's not trying to do too much. It's a somber piano ballad with some jazzy chord progressions. It's like crying your eyes out in a lounge, under a spotlight, dramatic as hell, although once again, I am catching Wise Blood vibes on this track too. Specifically, the song A Lot's Gonna Change. I will say that Angel edges out in front of that track though with a more theatrical presentation, as she really kills it at creating this vintage piece of heavily arranged vocal pop from maybe the 60s. Look, this thing is likable. I see the hype, I see why so many people are into it, and there are really only a few tracks that I was majorly disappointed by. A majority of them I think are either listenable, but I want more, or are pretty good. I appreciate that Angel is taking a trip outside of her comfort zone on this one, taking a major risk. I just personally am not too crazy about it. As, again, the personality and the voice from her music that I have loved so much up until this point just seems to suffer at the hand of this louder, more layered instrumentation when it didn't really need to be that way. I'm feeling a light to decent 6 on this one. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video for you to check out. That and the link to subscribe to the channel. You know what it is. Anthony Fantano, Angel Olsen, forever.